Let's talk about one of the important biological processes called photosynthesis and its stages. Here we will be discussing the light-dependent reaction and light-independent reactions. Light-independent reaction is also called the Kelvin cycle. We will also discuss a few examples, along with some common mistakes to get a clear understanding of the concept. Do you know how plants make their food? It's through the process of photosynthesis. In this process, the light energy is transformed into chemical energy in plants. This process is also found in certain organisms. The conversion of carbon dioxide and water into glucose takes place inside the chlorophyll, in leaves, in the presence of sunlight. The important part of this process is oxygen, which is released as a byproduct. After this conversion, the glucose molecules act as fuel to perform various activities inside the cell. The process of photosynthesis takes place in the green parts of the plant. The green parts of the plant are the specialized cells, known as mesophylls. Mesophylls consist of chloroplast, and that is where the process takes place. Inside the chloroplast, thylakoids are present, where the absorption of light at a certain wavelength takes place. The function of the pigment, chlorophyll, present inside the thylakoid is to convert solar energy into chemical energy. Photosynthesis is a multi-step process in which solar energy absorbed by chlorophyll, solar light energy converted to chemical energy, reduction of carbon dioxide into carbohydrates. The two stages in photosynthesis are light-dependent and light-independent reactions. The light-dependent reactions require a constant supply of solar energy and take place in the membrane of the thylakoid. Chlorophyll will absorb the light and convert it into chemical energy by forming molecules like ATP, adenosine triphosphate, which stores energy, and NADPH, nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate, which is an electron-bearing carrier. The water molecules here will be converted into the oxygen. The light-independent reactions, the Kelvin cycle, take place inside stroma and do not require direct sunlight. Light, when absorbed, is stored as ATP and NADPH, which function as fuel for further reaction. The Kelvin cycle uses the molecules from light-dependent reactions and fixes carbon dioxide to produce 3-carbon sugar glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, G3P molecules, which then form glucose. Common mistakes. Don't get confused between chlorophyll and chloroplast, as they hold different functions. Chlorophyll is the pigment that absorbs light and is found inside the chloroplasts. The chloroplast is the organelle where the process of photosynthesis takes place. The light-independent reactions are often termed the dark reactions, as they don't need light. Worked or real-world examples. As we all know, oxygen is essential for the sustainability of life on Earth. Also, glucose is an essential source of energy for human beings to survive. Both oxygen and glucose are produced in the process of photosynthesis. We discussed the two stages of photosynthesis and learned how plants are capable of making their food and releasing the oxygen gas that we breathe. The two types of reactions, which are light-dependent and light-independent, have also been discussed elaborately. In a nutshell, photosynthesis is the key process that helps in maintaining a balance between carbon dioxide and oxygen in the ecosystem.